Hey guys, from automating Excel using VBA in Germany to attending a coding bootcamp in Tokyo and now being a digital nomad, my journey has been quite an adventure. And today, as we are celebrating the 100,000 subscriber mark here on YouTube, yay! I want to share that story with you. This is going to be by far my most personal video here on my channel. And I will also talk about my current challenges I'm facing and also give you some insights on what to expect on the channel going forward. But before we dive into that, I want to say a huge thank you to all of you who watch my videos. And also a special shout out to those who clicked on the subscribe button and even taken the time to leave some comments under my videos. I can assure you that I read every single comment, even the negative ones, and I try to reply to as many as I can. So please keep sharing your thoughts under my videos. Okay, and with that said, let's dive into my story. My name is Sven, I'm German and I'm 35 years old. After graduation, I worked as a business analyst and BI specialist for a German company for about 10 years. During that time, I was involved in many data and automation projects, mainly using Excel and VBA. In 2019, my company sent me over to Tokyo, and it was during this time that I became really interested in learning Python. Before that, I had been written all my Excel automation projects in VBA, but I wanted to create interactive charts from Excel data, and Python seemed perfect for that. Plus, there was a huge hype around machine learning and deep learning, which made me even more curious. To learn Python, I began taking Udemy courses and watching YouTube tutorials. Now, a few months later, the pandemic hit, so I couldn't really travel. But instead of feeling stuck, I decided to make the most of the situation. I used all my vacation days to attend a 9-week full-time coding bootcamp in Tokyo, focusing on machine learning and deep learning. Fortunately, my company supported me, letting me take such a long break and even covering half of the expenses. And it was during this coding bootcamp that I started my YouTube channel. I just wanted to share everything I was learning in Python and some really cool VBA use cases. That is also why I called my website pythonandvba.com. Looking back, maybe I should have named it the same way as my channel or just use my own name. But, well, I'm sticking with that domain now. A few months later, the coding bootcamp also interviewed me about my experience and background. So if you're interested in learning more about my journey and career, you can check out that video. I will put the link in the description below. And on that note, if you would like to connect with me on LinkedIn, you can find the link there as well. On my LinkedIn page, you can, for example, read more about my different projects I was working on. Now, after completing the bootcamp and spending more time in Tokyo, I returned to Germany in December 2021. I continued working for the same company, but moved into a more technical role as a BI specialist. And my weeks became pretty routine. I had my full-time job, and before or after work, and especially on weekends, I was creating YouTube videos. In between, I'd go to the gym and later on started taking Muay Thai classes. After 3 years of that routine, I felt it was time for a change. I thought it would be great to just take a break and explore the world while I'm still relatively young. On my travels, I figured I could bring my laptop, stay productive, and hopefully also cover some of my expenses along the way. So at the beginning of this year, I made one of the hardest decisions of my life. I quit my job. And it was tough because I really loved my work. I'd been with the company for around 10 years, learned so much, and had amazing colleagues and managers. But my gut was telling me it was the right time to explore the world. So I listened to my instincts, quit my job, sold my lovely car, packed my bags, and now here I am on the road. First, I spent 2 months in the UK to brush up on my English skills, then spent 6 weeks in Bucharest, so Romania, and now I'm in Athens, Greece to learn boxing. Now, you might think that quitting my job would give me much more time to make YouTube videos, but interestingly, I've actually made viewer videos since then. The main reason is that I've been focusing more on my website, where I sell my Excel templates and add-ins. I've been working on the website design, improving my Excel solutions, and setting up all the backend automation processes, for example, what happens when a customer makes a purchase. I also set up an API for managing license keys and created onboarding videos and documentation for the different solutions. On top of that, I launched my new Excel add-in called Grafly, which lets you create interactive dashboards from Excel with just a couple of button clicks. And I also released CutePlots, which is a lighter version of Grafly, which creates cartoon-style charts. And more recently, I also updated my Excel templates to send bulk emails directly from your Gmail account. Developing all those solutions and creating the sales pages took quite a bit of time. But to be honest here, I actually enjoy working on these kind of Excel solutions and setting up all those automations. I'm sure you can relate to this. For me at least, it is super satisfying to create something from nothing just with code. And when an automation workflow works, it also saves me a ton of time. However, this brings me a bit of a dilemma. While I love building Excel solutions and creating automation workflows, without my YouTube channel, not many people would find my website and the tools I create. So I'm trying to figure out how to balance my passion for developing these tools with the need to produce engaging content for my channel. And at the same time, I've also noticed that some of my videos get a lot more attention than others. When I started out on YouTube, I was making tutorials on how to supercharge Excel using Python and VBA. Along the way, I made a tutorial on how to create a dashboard from Excel using Streamlit. Well, and that video gained a lot of interest and now has over 1 million views. After seeing the interest in web development with Python, I made more tutorials on Streamlit and even covered tools like TyPy and just recently FastHTML. So this brings me now to my challenge. What kind of videos should I publish on YouTube? When I take a look at my YouTube stats, I see there's much more interest in Streamlit and Python web development compared to my Excel tutorials. But as I just mentioned, my Excel tutorials are actually the ones who drive traffic to my website, which leads to sales that help me to pay my bills. On top of that, I recently learned a lot about no-code automation tools. And I'm also thinking about making tutorials on these as well. And to be really honest with you, and actually also to myself, what I really love doing is creating Excel templates and add-ins. That's my true passion, and I've built my whole website around it. So I'm really not sure which direction to take. If you have any good ideas, please let me know in the comments. For now, I've decided to keep making both, so my Streamlit and also Excel automation tutorials, while also building Excel solutions and promoting them here on my channel. Additionally, I'm planning to create some video courses. I know this is what every YouTuber does, but it just makes sense. If someone wants to learn in a more structured way, I think video courses can be super helpful. I'm planning to create smaller, more concise courses on how to automate Excel using Python and how to create your own Excel add-ins. Mainly because I've learned so much about this over the past few years, and if I had to start over, I wish I had a resource like this. So to show you what options you have when it comes to automating Excel with Python, along with some really practical use cases. On the other hand, I also want to bundle all my knowledge about creating and selling Excel add-ins. I will include my tips and tricks, the tools I use, and how to handle things like license key distribution and much more. So if someone is interested in creating or even selling their own Excel solutions, they will have all the knowledge they need in one place. Now, many of you also ask me about a Streamlit course. While I like the idea, I'm a bit hesitant. Streamlit is constantly evolving, which is of course exciting, but it also means I will have to keep up any course up to date with the latest features. On the other hand, topics like Excel automation and especially the add-in course are a bit more evergreen. But either way, if you're interested in these courses and you want to grab an early bird discount once they are released, you can sign up on my website. Just follow the link in the description and it will take you to this page here, where you can vote for the course you are most interested in. And if you drop your email, you will be notified as soon as I'm about to release it. So, and that is basically where I am right now. Sharing all of this with you guys has been a bit nerve-wracking to me, to be honest, but I hope it gives you a better idea of who I am and also where I'm heading. I was actually also planning to answer some questions you might have, but under my latest YouTube post, there weren't too many questions. So if you have now any questions or comments, just leave them below under this video, and then I will do a dedicated Q&A video. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Cheers!